tackling his arm.
Okay.
Oh, look, I got him.
Good shot.
Hello, everyone. This is Jeff of Taofledermaus. If you watch my channel, there's a good chance you also watch this guy's channel. That's right. Let me show you his features. This, of course, is Joerg Spray from Germany, the slingshot guy. Recently, Joerg had a guest on his channel. I believe he was an archaeologist. And this gentleman brought some examples of some ancient slingshot projectiles that they found in a dig in Scotland that were used by the invading Romans around 2000 AD. Now, what was unusual about these projectiles was they had little holes drilled in them. Since they weren't completely sure what the point of the hole was, Joerg created his own projectiles with a hole in them. When Joerg shot these from his slingshot, they made a very loud whistling sound. So they believed that the point of the hole in the projectile was for psychological warfare, to make a scary sounding projectile. I will have a link to his video at the end of this video, don't worry. It'll also be a link in the description. And I highly recommend watching it because you'll fully understand the whole context and history involved. We will, of course, be using a shotgun to propel our projectile, and our projectile will be a cube made out of lead. Now, despite it being a cube shape, the projectile worked fantastic, and it was actually very accurate, and it also tumbled a lot. So we'll do a simple modification by drilling a hole to the same specifications that Joerg used in his video. Now, as a comparison, we'll shoot an unmodified cube. Then we'll shoot a cube with a slight dent in it, kind of a dimple. Then we'll shoot one with the same dimensions that Joerg used, a 4 millimeter hole that's about 6 millimeters deep. And then finally the Mickey Mouse round, which has 3 holes in it, one large one in the center and 2 smaller ones. Now looking down our road, we can see our full-size ballistic dummy way down there, and we will be launching these things at close to supersonic speeds. Now, will these cube slugs perform like Joerg's spherical slugs, and traveling at those high velocities, will they make any weird sounds? Now the plain cube slug did not make any sounds up to the point till it hit the ground, and then it began spinning at a higher rate, and then it made a sound.
This is the dimple?
Yep.
The dimple slug did pretty much the same thing. It hissed, hit the ground, then we heard a whine. Now, surprisingly, this one didn't make a notable chirping sound either. So what's going on here? None of these slugs were accurate enough to hit the dummy. However, the Mickey Mouse slug fortunately came through and actually chirped as it flew through the air. Why? You tell me. Now, since we have a few of these slugs left over, we're going to bring everything a lot closer and shoot at some ballistic gel and bring back a very special friend. Chakotay!
We're less than 10 yards away, right?
Yeah, I'd say this is probably 10 yards.
Okay, hit it.
Now today we have 5 of the ballistic gel gummy bears. The slug managed to go through all 5. That's about 15 inches of gel in reality. And that's pretty much to be expected with a solid, non-expanding slug. And of course, a cube-shaped slug leaves a square hole. We didn't see a whole lot of energy when the slug hit. We've shot these things with much more powerful slugs, and they just stretched and contorted all over the place.
Okay, anytime.
Something skipped out of there.
Yeah.
See a nice big splash because these gummies are all wet. We keep them in a water bath, otherwise they just melt in the sun. But once again, the slug managed to go through all five gummy bears.
Nice little cube-shaped entrance from the cube-shaped...
Yeah, we shot them on the flat side this time.
Yeah.
Okay, center mass?
Center mass.
Okay, hit it.
I think we hit him.
This is definitely the shot you've been waiting for. It's kind of hilarious. Watch as he does like a perfect cartwheel. And that white wiggly thing, I don't even know what to say about that. I don't know if this shot was better or in the BORG bullet video where Nick shot him in the head and he did a 1.5 head twist. He's definitely an Olympic hopeful though.
This is the scene of the crime. We've found the victim laying here, missing one arm. We'll roll him over. Rigor mortis has set in, but you can see the square puncture in the
pretty accurate
uniform.
That's where you're aiming, right? You called it.
That's what, he's no longer with us, though. It did sever the arm.
Pity the fool.
And blew out his back, taking with it his plastic lungs and heart. Square-shaped, cube-shaped impact wound.
I don't think you get more center mass than that without,
you know, really. For a shotgun, that's pretty
that's
clear.
Pretty good.
I don't know.
That's a kind of a cool shirt. I wonder where you get those.
Yeah, I got this at a concert once. This is available on the Taofledermaus channel. You click the link down below, and it took me right to a site where you can pick these up for under $25, and it arrived at my door in about 4 days.
It's not bad.
Couldn't get easier than that. Everyone go out there, pick one up.
Well, that is all for today. Thank you and bye-bye. Oh, wait, we forgot about Joerg. Don't forget to check out his video on the whistling bullets. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching.